him, and that's their biggest asset over on Dignitas.
And they have all been to LAN. They have all been top four in LAN? Triple Trouble didn't make it to top four. They almost made it. They were like top eight. They were top four in my heart. An early press here from Dignitas. They will start in the orange, Barcelona in the blue. Our second match in week three in Europe. Violent Panda high aloft. Devo tries to hold on to this one and does. Devo's car no longer tingly. He's been using that sparkle paint all season. Now he's just going with the anodized pearlescent. Over onto the wall. Here comes Bluey. Yukio's got him beat. Ronicky in his own corner. Actually, he kind of stalls his entire team out there by blocking the rotation, but he'll be able to carry it out and recover. Now Yukio looking for Astral in the midfield. Astral up for it, and Bluey's got him beat. Now Ronicky on the far side. He'll just take the shot. Violent Panda will have to save. Here's a follow-up from Devo. Lofted again. Ronicky still with boost to work with. Get on the backboard once more. Now Bluey continuing to keep this ball trapped in the box. Devo can't quite get that read, though. It looks like Dignitas will dodge this press.
And the most important person on this Dignitas roster, I actually don't think is going to be Astro. Yes, he is their biggest asset, but I think the most important player in winning this match for Dignitas is going to be Yukio. He's going to be the third man back, and whenever Dignitas gets a chance, he's going to be the guy coming out of the midfield trying to put it away. So if his shooting's on point, they could have a chance here.
Ronicky's up, and we'll put it to his own corner. Here's Violent Panda with a shot from the side corner. It goes off the post and out. Looked like a good shot to me, but it's not going to result in a goal. They're going to need more than that to score from Barcelona. Here's Ronicky with a shot from midfield. It's high. Bluey positioned well to put it back into the midfield, but neither of his teammates really in position to make use of it. Ronicky on the far side is able to connect back with Bluey. It's back into the box. And Astral will dribble it past Devo. Now he and Violent Panda flying down the field. They'll get the bump on Ronicky, but he still makes the play. Gets it off to the side. Will stay scoreless in game number one.
Huge save from Barca. But they're not done yet. They've been putting on pressure on Dignitas. And to their credit, it has been handled well. No demos able to come through. No really having to deal with strong infield passes. Dignitas have held off this offense quite well.
Stevo through the air, using all of his boosts at midfield. Now Ronicky playing this high. Astral will get it to his teammate, Violent Panda. Now Yukio up. All of Dignitas winning their challenges, getting the ball first. Here's Devo out. Ronicky extending the play all the way into the corner. So across halftime, here's a shot from Bluey. Yukio's got the save. Follow up from Ronicky a bit slow. Devo now on the wall. Here's Bluey. Backboard, Yukio out to Astral, extends it past the frontline defense.
Whoa,
and all the way back actually makes it as the post helps him out once more.
Quite fortunate there for Barca. That was, I mean, there's no other word for it. That was free. And it pings off the post to give Devo a chance at it. That's luck.
Gotta shoot better from your own box, I guess.
Yeah.
Here's Astral. Under Devo to Yukio. Tries to glance it off of his side wall. Here's Astral with a shot. Doesn't find it, but Yukio finds a follow-up. Bluey's got the block, but Violent Panda will finally finish it. Dignitas is on the board.
Good patience here from Violent Panda. He knows his two teammates should have this under control. Bluey, unfortunate, slightly too far forward, catches it off the side of the car instead of the nose. And that means Violent Panda gets a gimme.
1:38 on the clock. Barcelona yet to score. Astral through the air. Challenge against Devo is good. See Yukio put it into the corner and nearly get it into the goal from the corner. Again, off the woodwork and out. Through two here. Bluey up over the top of Violent Panda. Astral to the edge. Takes a shot. Bluey's got the stop. 107 on the clock. Bluey through one, now advancing down the field, a pop up, here's Yukio, and Ronicky will challenge Bluey, bumping Astral in the neck, and Ronicky find the double tap, he sure can, what a play, set up by his teammate, Ronicky will finish it.
Great transition here, Yukio, it's a decent challenge, but it's the bump attempt from Bluey in the net on Astral that slows down the approach, and he can't get up there to block that double tap. It's a matter of technique for Ronicky and a big goal to equalize under a minute.
Ooh, we're able to feature it in the pre-show, Bluey and Ronicky. Really a tag team on offense on many of the best goals for Barcelona. But here comes Yukio with a follow-up. He beams it off the post. Here's Violent Panda in. and Ronicky will be able to get the save.
I told you, Yukio's the guy to put away the chances. If he's not shooting well, it's going to be a tough day at the office for Dignitas.
Devo now, off the wall, towards Bluey. Has Bluey closed the gap? Not quite. Final panda now.
What a takeaway!
1v2 Astral will get it. No, it's off the woodwork. Pilot Panda will finish this one. He's tired of his teammates missing the dang goal, and he finishes it off himself.
That was just a beautiful touch from Violent Panda straight down and across. And yes, that's two he's had to clean up off the post now. And thank goodness the veteran world champion will turn in another one.
That entire goal from like beginning to end was just every important touch we felt like was Violent Panda.
Yeah.
Ronicky over to the side, Devo sends this one long. Dignitas now back with the lead with 18 seconds left to go. Bluey puts this one high. His teammate Ronicky will come in, but Violent Panda's already there. Now Yukio towards the goal. Devo play it to the side. He'll pick up the boost, but gets bumped in the meantime. Now Ronicky trying to get it back to Devo. Can he get the solid full court carry here? It's out to Bluey. It's popped up. Bluey's got some boost to work with underneath Yukio, though. Oh, Devo's in! Over the top, Violent Panda double commits alongside his teammate, but Ronicky can't get it to the wall. A nice attempt, solid defense. Dignitas sneak away with game one.
Nice play there from Barca on the push at the end, but Ronicky trying to make sure I think he got in his own head a little bit about how to catch it. You could see him feathering his boost on the ground. And he just didn't use enough to really get under that ball and get it strongly out into the corner of the pitch. So, well done, Dignitas. Violent Panda, you said, you know, he's tired of his teammates missing the post. And here's that great touchdown to take it away from Ronicky. And an excellent pass. And yes, there to clean up, but it goes back to even when he was playing with Turbo and K-Dop. I mean, that guy was still a big goal scorer on that team.
He was always the cleanup man, always the quiet back line, but the anchor of the legendary roster of Dignitas. And that's how rotations work. Rotation and positioning in Rocket League is basically give your teammates the best chance to do the good thing and be in the place to help out if they don't.
Enable your teammates to be successful. Give them options.
But be in the place that when they don't do it, you're able to bail them out.
As I like to say to a couple friends when they play, trust your teammates, but do not believe they will hit it. That's what I like to say.
Isn't that what trust is? I don't know. Like, I guess it's just giving
you can trust. You can pass the ball to your teammate and trust that they will be there. Don't believe they're going to score.
Don't go for the next. Like, I'm going to give you the ball, and I'm going to go over here. Yeah. No. So Violent Panda gets that one. Yukio and Astral both get assists on the two goals that Violent Panda was able to score, and those are the only goals that mattered there. Six shots Violent Panda was able to put up, a total of 14 for Dignitas, forcing seven saves out of Barcelona.
Yeah.
There's a lot of, which means there's a lot, when you have 14 shots and seven saves and only two goals going, that does mean a lot of woodwork is happening here. A lot of crossbars and posts are being hit. You got to find a way to put it between the posts a little bit more. And honestly, I think if Dignitas was able to do that, we'd see them with a very different record right now.
And seven saves as well. But yeah, you probably would see Dignitas. If they keep putting up numbers like that, 14 a game, if you average around 10 shots a game, you're definitely going to be one of the strongest offenses in the entire league. And if Dignitas is putting up average of 10 and scoring 2,
yeah,
something's wrong. It's just the finishing isn't very good. Violent Panda had to clean up both of these off the post. Yukio had a couple of shots that he could have placed well, and that was the whole thing when he was initially part of that Dignitas roster, taking the shoes of K-Dop. You need to be the guy to put the chances away.
Yeah.
And so when you're having to have Violent Panda be the cleanup guy or Astral making an incredible solo play to put it in an open net, you're going to struggle.
For sure, and we are waiting on a player connection to sort itself out, make sure we can maintain the competitive integrity and everybody gets to play under a situation they consider fair, so we'll have game two in just a moment. The biggest question for me in this matchup, I think, was Devo, which he's kind of been my biggest question mark.
Yeah.
Like, I'm going to be honest, ever since he won the World Championship in Season 3, he's been a player that's been like, huh, I feel like you used to be able to be a lot better than you are right now. And he just continues to like have moments where I'm like, I expect greatness out of him, and then the play is fine. It's just normal.
And you make a good point. I think Devo is my key factor for Barca because, I mean, I already know Bluey's going to be really aggressive, and that is its own thing. That's neither good nor bad. It's how Bluey approaches the game. He will force defenses to respect and figure out what he's trying to do. Ronicky, I feel, is a lot of that in game number one. He was really just going for the smash it into an open space and go for a demo or just play as needed. Devo's sort of the quiet third guy now, which is just very strange to me.
Yeah.
Because it's as you said, it's Bluey and Ronicky who have been a lot of the scoring for Barca. So when your player is Devo, the guy in charge of damage control, when he was just an absolute monster, it's like, what happened, man?
Yeah.
He used to be a beast.
Well, and I
not that
like,
he's not good, right?
No, but obviously like, he's one of the best players in the world. But it's you feel like, I do wonder how much of that is me kind of like getting the turbo pulsa on NRG syndrome of like, is either two players playing really well, you just need your third man just to kind of like hold down the fort in the back. But I feel like this is even quieter than turbo pulsa has been on NRG.
Yeah.
And they are losing games where NRG is not losing any games. So it's like no matter how quiet turbo's being, it doesn't matter if they're winning.
If they're winning, yeah. And it kind of goes back to, I believe it was week one where just Devo just had an awful shooting week. He had like a bunch of open nets, and like I remember like the Reddit post is like Beanvo and stuff, and it's like ooh.
Wow.
It's just like he did not have a good week.
Yeah.
And after that, it's just been as needed, I'll do what I can. So you really want to see Devo come out here and have a good week. Because there were times during the offseason.
Well, and how much for a player like Devo? I mean, I've never had this conversation with him, so I don't know if this is where he's at. But how much with a player like this is it about, like, I pioneered the double tap. Like, that is my thing. And now I have to sit on this back line? No, I'm going to be a star player. Oh, wait, now I'm out of position, you know? Like,
ooh,
here he comes starting with some offense, but Yukio will shut him down. You have to kind of get into a new mental space, though, to be okay with being that torment, that fire burner, that now turbo pulsa, just hold down the anchor on the back line and let the stars do their thing.
But Devo is my big key, because even during the offseason, he had a lot of great presence on the pitch. Even if it wasn't goal scoring or saving tough shots, he was getting possession. He was a huge midfield force, and there's a ball for Ranaki denied by Yukio, but I just want to see Devo be in charge of getting his team the ball.
Just trying to get it to Bluey here. We've got game two underway. It's been mostly Barcelona on offense. Another attempt here, but the defense gets in front of it. Now Astral back to midfield. Devo will play some defense, pop it to the side. Bluey will try to follow this, but it's an awkward bounce to Reed. Ronicky will have to do some work. Now back in the box again. Ronicky, three touches in a row for his team, and now Devo over the top of one. Astral will carry it off to the wall and look for the carry. Licks one, Ronicky up, bops to the side. Devo now, lofted at midfield. You go with a counter, Ronicky over the top of him and now into the orange territory. Off the backboard, no one touched it. Ronicky's home, gets the block on the one. Bluey tries and Violet Panda falls on it. The Dignitas defense holding on clean and now looking for the counterattack.
Oh, that was a nice bump though from Devo on the rotation out. It allows Barca to stay on offense here, and it's rolling around the backboard, and they are just all over these clears. They made a great save, but they gotta relieve this pressure somehow.
Violet Panda with an attempt, and Bluey shuts him down. Now the ball dropping back down, dangerous. Ronicky can't wrap it around the post. Nashville will hold onto this one, just maintain close ball control. Bluey, the challenge of midfield, be able to dunk Yukio, who was up to stop him. Now Violet Panda with an attempt. Astral back to midfield. Violent Panda, can he find his teammates? Drops this one straight down. Devo will go up on an awkward bounce as well. Now out of boost, just trying to stall it out. Doesn't really work out for anything, but Dignitas doesn't advance with control, so Barcelona get another opportunity to score.
But it has evened out, because now it's no longer Barca pressuring Dignitas around their own net. This is just a battle sort of in the middle of the pitch to see who wins the next couple of big challenges. And while it may be being played on Dignitas' half, Barca don't really have much control over where the ball is going.
Ronicky out of his own back third, and then Astral leaves it. Devo with an attempt, Yukio pressing forward. Bluey and Devo, nice extension into the midfield, but immediately pushed back against a Violent Panda. Now Ronicky looked for the bump on Astral, didn't find it. Bluey with a shot from midfield, easily defended by Yukio. Violent Panda will make an attempt to push out, but just doesn't quite get there. 1:58 left to go, still scoreless across halftime in game number two. Dignitas won game number one, looking to extend that here, and Barcelona would love to bounce back and tie it up.
And Devo is having a pretty good game. He's only got 80 points, but he's always in position. He's making blocks, and this one finally slips by him, but he's got help, and here's a pass down, a chance to do something big. Pass off the ceiling, and Ronicky will not have much of an angle. Just kidding!
You were like, oh, he's got a chance. I'm
like,
no, there's no way. Absolutely no way this ball goes in. What a shot! Oh, my goodness. Two defenders in net. They both were like, yeah, he's not hitting it. Let's you guys ready to clear this off the post? Yeah, me too. Let's go. Oh, wait, it's in the back of the net. Wow. There's the lead for Barcelona in game two. 1:35 left to go. We'll see if they can hold on to it.
You know, Ronicky, way to not give up on that one.
Yeah, we all gave up on it.
I'm pretty sure everyone watching gave up on that one.
Everyone was like, they turned to, like, take another handful of chips.
Yeah.
And looked like, wait, what? What? Devo will get a block in net.
2-on-1.
Trying to
look
pressure.
Look at Louis. He's hunting down Astral there. Great job to get away from that.
Oh, Ronicky with an attempt. It's over the top of Devo, and that one definitely is not possible. Louis with the turn on one. Catches. Air carries. Yukio up to challenge, and he dunks it in. Was this a Yukio own goal?
Oh, no. This is a Bluey dunk, 100%. I mean, he beats Violent Panda. Yukio's trying to take the ball across, and Devo just sits right on it.
I mean, the trail is orange, but
it kicks off his nose. But
yeah,
it's because Bluey just had such a great challenge angle. It kicks off the outside of Yukio's car and into his own corner. That's a great challenge.
Two spectacular goals for Barcelona in the waning moments of game two. That's definitely how you get some momentum back on your side. Just got to hold on for 50 more seconds. The Dignitas will drop this one. Getting on the board, definitely the name of the game right now for Dignitas. Just keep some momentum on your side. Don't let things get out of hand. Zoroniki onto the backboard once more. Looks like Bluey wants to challenge it. Just opting to play safe instead of drive the point home. Defend the back line. 25 seconds left. Two demolitions. This is actually an opportunity here. Violent Panic can get this around, but Ronicky cleans that one up. Defense is going to hold on just fine, despite it being a momentary 3v1.
Dig really was going for the big demo plays. And even here, Yukio is just going to drive towards the net and just try and push people away to give himself time. Astral towards the middle. Ronicky diving across and a nice save, but Barca. Couple of awesome shots. I honestly still don't know how that Ronicky one ended up in the back of the net.
Both the goals. I'm like, all right, cool. This was a nice attempt, but it's already over. And then it happened. I just gotta stop. I just gotta expect everything. Like, oh, he's in his own net. He's going for the save. Does he pinch it off the crossbar for a long 150 mile per hour laser beam? Anything's possible with this Barcelona offense here. Seven shots for Ronicky. We'll get another closer look here.
It's like Violent Panda, like, look how far that ball goes out into the corner. It's basically stuck against the wall.
I want it from his perspective. I want to see how close this ball comes to the post.
How do you
watching
score
the
that?
Ring on the bottom. You see the ring kind of, like, right up the post there. It looks like the ball is going to hit the post no
how
matter
do you
what.
Score that, man?
That's insane. What a play. What a game. All right, tied up at one apiece here. Going into game three.
Great offensive game.
Was there anything you noticed in particular from Dignitas that was different that enabled Barcelona here? I mean, again, I can't even, like, really look at this game and be like, oh, that was a mistake on Dignitas' part.
No,
I mean,
it really wasn't.
Because both the goals that happened were kind of
huge plays,
abstract, out there, outlier goals.
No, Dignitas really didn't do anything wrong. It was just Barca won a couple of big challenges. Again, Devo's the biggest part of that, in my opinion, when it comes to Barca. I mean, he really wasn't doing much. Up until Ronicky scored, the dude had 80 points. He was just driving around the midfield like, okay, you can't go that way. Okay, you can't go that way. Okay, you can't go that way. And that's all he had to do. He didn't do anything special. Dignitas was making half-decent challenges. Just Devo was winning them.
Well, we move into game three, all tied up in the series. One game apiece. Now Astral looking for an early goal. His shot is just wide, and Bluey able to put it away. But some bumps on the goal line, some inner team bumping from Barcelona might create an opportunity as Astral now up against Bluey. Bluey getting crowded, but able to get the save, no problem.
And Dignitas feeling like they want to pick up right where they left off. Very physical at the end of that game, too. Curious to see if they keep trying to get all those demos as Devo pushes Astral to respawn.
Dignitas advancing on offense. Yukio attempting to get it out of this blue corner. And Astral passed one. Now Bluey up. Devo out of his own box. He's got Yukio and Astral pressuring him. He gets it through two. Violent Panda moving back to goal. Here's Ronicky up against Yukio. Off the wall, towards the goal. Violent Panda's got it away. Is the third man coming in? No. Astral will get it all the way back down the field. First minute will come and go with no one getting on the board.
You can see that philosophy in Violent Panda as well. He'd rather make a poor clear that dribbles out into the top of the box than let it go across his net. And that is understandable when you're... Oh, that's a tough bounce. And not finished off. Bluey could not get it. Violent Panda didn't make the read off the top corner. And unfortunately, Barcelona not able to capitalize.
They're lucky they didn't get counterattacked either. I believe that was all three Barcelona players in the orange box.
Yeah.
It's Bluey now. Back on the field up against Yukio over to the side. Deagle's got him red now. Can he find the pass into the midfield? Here comes Ronicky. Just bounces high.
That's just great support from Ronicky as well.
Steve-O will look to find Bluey here underneath him. Can't quite connect it. It's Astral now up. Great challenge. Ronicky blocks that one and then hangs behind the ball. A nice block positioning there. Looked like Dignitas still able to get it past him, but about the best job he could. Now here's Violent Panda looking to double tap. This Bluey will say no. I'm going to put that right back onto the backboard for you and then get the dunk on Astral all the way back down the field. Is going to go for Booze, look for some demos as well, but Yukio, an excellent challenge, an important challenge in the midfield to break up that push that was materializing into quite the scoring opportunity for Barcelona.
You know, something tells me this entire series is going to be 0-0 until like the minute 30 for the rest of this series. It's just no one's doing anything crazy or making any glaring mistakes other than Violent Panda not being able to make a tough read. And even then, that's not a mistake. That's just a tough play.
Well, there's a shot from Ronicky. Violent Panda's got it away. And I agree with you. I feel like the midfield right now is very 50-50.
Yeah.
Both teams are having their victories here and there.
Here's some space.
Oh, Violent Panda with the flick, and it's in past Devo. 2:10 on the clock, and that's Dignitas on the board.
Finally comes down to having an uncontested approach, and nice job from Violent Panda. Do not rush the play. You've got space, take the dribble, and he turns it into an awesome flick on net and gets a goal for it.
Can Barcelona find the response? Strong solo play for Violent Panda, going to result in the goal. What is the response here? The nice infield pass. Bluey's shot was good, but Yukio's got the save. Now back down the field. Gets demolished as he tries to clear it out. And a high loft. Devo in challenge. Loses it to Astral, who puts it past Bluey as well. Now all of Barcelona has to fly back onto defense. Bluey with no boost, but a flip reset to work with. Going to leave it for Ronicky. Get it back to the orange corner, no problem.
Devo not getting his hands on any of the challenges this time around as well, making it tough to build pressure on that Dignitas net.
Bluey looking for demos. Ronicky, can he find Devo here? He actually just goes for the shot himself, but Astral comes in from the side and clears it out. Now Bluey up onto the wall. Yukio making it his best effort. Ronicky back in the midfield. Nobody wants to touch this ball. Bluey now back to Ronicky. Can he find Devo? Just takes the shot himself instead. The soft one's easily defended by Yukio. Bluey will keep this pressure on, keep it in the blue, or in the orange rather, but the rest of his team had fallen back. That'll be the end of that drive. They'll look to reset.
Very tough touch there from Ronicky to get that all the way across to Devo. Has to fight his momentum, the awkward angle of the ball on the car. Yukio's got a great read. Devo, strong save, and that will keep them in contention here under a minute and a helpful pinch as Yukio has to give a little ground but wins the next ball.
Yukio threatening in the corner. Ronicky plays it over his head. Here's Astral. Drop it back to Violent Panda. Shots onto the backboard. Ronicky's up for it.
Gotta
but Yukio's is as well. It's off the crossbar. Astral's is as well. The misses flood in for Dignitas. And now the counterattack back down against Violent Panda. I believe Yukio is rotating into goal. But is it going to be enough? Here's the touch back up. Bluey goes for Astral. He's got it into the corner. A dangerous position to not have scored. Now down by one. With Barcelona threatening in the final moments, the panic's going to set in here as Bluey just looks for the aerial bump on the defense. Devo's up first over the top of two. Can he double tap it in? Oh, Devo! He'll come back to RLCS, and he's got the game tied up.
That's why you got to score the ball, Dignitas. You had a chance to put the game away. Barcelona takes what you give them, drive back the other way, and Devo scores a banger.
Man, season three flashbacks. It's beautiful. Good to see Devo scoring again. And Dignitas, man, they are kicking themselves they didn't score. And then the 15 seconds prior. Now 5 seconds left. Barcelona could possibly take a lead at demolition, could open it up. There's 1 second left. Ronicky in to keep that ball alive. It's around and nobody's in the goal. Yukio will play it off to the side, and that one should kill it. We'll go to overtime in game number three. What a result.
Yukio misses the goal scoring chance. Astral misses the follow-up. And now they find themselves in overtime. Dignitas lose this. Oh, that's going to be so frustrating.
You lose this, you're talking about possibly just losing the series at that moment. The momentum, the frustration of having been so close and having lost it. You've got to win this overtime. Bluey up. Over the top, here's Ronicky. Towards the goal, Yukio's got it. Astral in support, as well as Vinyl Panda, sending three men into enemy territory. Yukio will fall back. Now Bluey off the wall. Yukio drops back down. Bluey turned around instead of looking for demos. And Astral will try to clear. Devo's touch, not really useful. Bluey will pass into Ronicky. Shot towards the goal, the block from Yukio. Out to Astral. The pass back to Yukio to get this one back away and kind of distract from the fact that Vinyl Panda got demolished on the back line.
Definitely an awkward touch to handle, though, for Dignitas. Look at Devo just trying to push Violent Panda off the ball, which isn't necessarily a bad idea, as he would have had an opportunity had he gotten the bump to pass that ball out. Astral with no boost, though. This is all Devo. Not a good clear.
Here's Violent Panda. Back to Astral. The shot on target, and Dignitas make up for their earlier mistakes. They'll get the win in Game 3. Now move on to match point.
Four clear from Devo. Violent Panda finds Astral. That's what he was so good at with Turbo and K-Dop, and he still got it on the nose and turned in, and that is just a counter from Dignitas. Do not tap a ball off your ceiling in the middle of your box.
We have had celebrations in Rocket League for, I don't know, six seasons or something now in RLCS. And so few teams have ever coordinated dances.
It used to be a lot more popular.
It would happen, but it would still, like, one team in a season would do it three times or something like that. I still wish that was more of a thing. Well, we see it every broadcast, every game.
Clearly, the biggest reason we don't have those is because, you know, they're too busy thinking about how to win the game instead of just knowing they're going to win the game.
They don't have time to dance when they're, like, sitting back, wiping the sweat
they're
off
like,
their brow.
I made a terrible clear.
I can't believe we were that close in Game 3. But, all right, they get away with that one. And while I did think that was a must-win overtime for Dignitas, not necessarily the same situation for Barcelona. They were like, okay, this game was rough. Hey, we got ourselves an opportunity in overtime. We didn't quite get it. It's all right. Let's do it again in Game 4 here. But Barcelona now up against match point. They've got to win two.
Yeah, got to win two, and I think they've got the tools to do it. You can see, 11 shots. They kept Dignitas under a fair amount of pressure, but some nice adaptions. Devo definitely not winning as many balls. Dignitas able to break out, get the ball out of their own half, get unstuck, and so it was a much more even game. But
and the midfield was so contested on both sides. Yeah. No team really had control there, which really does dictate the pace in Rocket League.
Yeah.
It kind of puts one team onto the opportunity of, like, we're going to try have a lot of opportunities to score, and the other team's like, well, we just got to go for the few counterattacks we get.
Pretty much.
Strong.
It came down to people not making the optimal choice or not able to execute a tough play.
Now on to Game 4. Can Dignitas finish it off right here? Does Barcelona find a way to get us to Game 5? Sronicky high. Bluey's there. Towards the goal. This one's still over the top of the crossbar. Sronicky and Devo will look to work together. Astral hits this one. Bluey through one and now through two. Violent Panda over the top and onto the backboard. Devo will try and do his best, but doesn't really make any solid contact here. What a pass and what a shot. Violent Panda starting to rotate back. It's like, you know what? I think I can do a little bit more damage.
It's literally the same thing as how overtime is. Miss the clear. Pass to your teammate. And turn it into a goal.
The fact that Bluey was on his ceiling, on the ceiling of the goal, like, I see this positioning. I know where this shot's coming. And he was actually pretty close to saving it. Absolutely monstrous play from a wonderful player. Now Dignitas with the early lead. They have the early lead in Game 3 as well, and it slipped away in the final moments. See if they can hold on to it this time and maybe get that security blanket.
I think Bluey definitely has been the fastest player on this pitch. Feels like the first one up. And it has earned his team a couple of favorable positions, but hasn't really found the back of the net too much. One goal, one assist. And that is a credit to Dignitas' strong defense.
Some nice artillery shots here from the midfield. Violent Panda's challenge was defended, and then the follow-up was over their head. So Yukio, last push from Dignitas. Devo will look to get this one out, but Violent Panda back to Astral. It's high once more as Yukio here for a follow-up. Here comes the shot, but he's so far away. The defense should have time, but he gets two out of them. Neither of them make contact. Ronicky grounds himself in time. The pass back, and this one defended by Devo. Can Ronicky find a counterattack now after what was seemed like a guaranteed goal for Dignitas. They survive. The defense gets all the blocks they need. And again, the infield pass is high. Here's Yukio for one last attempt off the crossbar. Violent Panda to pass to Astral. The backflip shot. Oh, and it's off the post. Bluey, can Astral finish it? I don't know what is happening. Nobody can shoot well. The defense is trying their best. And Barcelona now on the other side looking for the tying goal.
Great pressure from Dignitas. They might catch him on the counterattack. Ronicky's racing back, and Astral cannot push it by him. And Barca, you guys. Oh, man. Take a deep breath, but you guys are going to have to do some mending on your clothes.
There's like not even close. Not no, no. What are you talking about, Chiefs?
A lot of bullet holes.
I didn't see that ball going the goal one time. It's fine. 2:20 left to go, just past halftime. And Dignitas still holding on to the lead that could have been slightly larger with ever so slightly better shooting. Another opportunity here, but a much more difficult one. Yukio not quite able to get that one around the post. Now Astral off his own backboard. Back over to the side. Gets it into the corner. Bluey to follow this one out, but loses it to Yukio. Devo needs to make this touch, and he does. Over the top of Violent Panda, and Astral is able to close that gap from the back line. Gets the demolition on Aroniki, looks for some more, but not going to find any. Yukio with an opportunity, shot to the far post. Devo's got the save.
Expecting Devo to dive across, tried to go behind him. Unfortunately, ended up putting it pretty much on Devo. It's again a late game scenario for Barca, down by one. They've done it before, even in this series. Oh. That's another poor clear. Devo. That's three.
Honestly, Devo on this shot, I thought this was in. I was like, he's so slow to this. He looked like he was farther back, too, from the first perspective we had. And yeah, no power on that. Violent Panda happy to clean up. World champ versus world champion there. And Violent Panda comes out on top. Now up by two goals, 1:24 left to go. It looks like they could do this in four games.
And to be honest, I'm probably being too harsh on Devo. That touch really wasn't that bad. Violent Panda just made a great read on it, to be fair.
Still slow.
Did not get a strong touch. But
out to the corner.
It was a tough play.
Here's Violent Panda to try and finish another one off. Here's Astral in, and it just completely airballs that. Here comes Bluey now to move it into the corner. Can he find a teammate? They need a goal right now. There's Ronicky in, and he puts the goal in with 57 seconds left. Barcelona's got a chance.
And got life, and that's just Bluey on a great transition up the pitch, having to fight off Violent Panda and not get demoed, and Yukio just doesn't make the read off the bounce. Not expecting a hard press for Barca. It takes a pretty passive line to it, and Ronicky just takes it away.
Ronicky and Bluey. Front line of offense for Barcelona. They keep the dream of game five alive. Devo to stall this one. Bluey in, but it won't happen. Yukio was trying to push that one forward, but now Bluey onto the backboard. Violent Panda's not there, but neither is he. Ronicky onto the goal line, and Yukio makes the save. Devo couldn't find the follow-up, and what could have been the tying goal comes and goes. 30 seconds left. Ronicky airborne loses the challenge. It's onto the goal line. Devo's clears. Not great. Astral shot finally on target, but Devo makes the follow-up save. What a play. And now, 20 seconds left. Dignitas still trying to put the nail in the coffin. Ronicky, the long shot. Astral's not there. It's in. Ronicky's howitzer from midfield ties the game.
Oh, what is this? Ronicky to himself, and he just booms it. Doesn't care. Astral can't reach it. And wow, what a bomb from Ronicky.
And they're tied back up. Man, game three vibes. Can they keep this one into overtime? Can they end it in regulation? Do we have a game five? Or does Dignitas do it again and find a way to finish it off in the final moments?
Oh, a couple of great challenges from Ronicky to keep things going. Bluey off the wall. Devo, that's a tough read. All right.
I think we're going to overtime.
Let's go to overtime.
All right. Game four overtime. One goal from Dignitas secures them the win. Their second win in the RLCS Season 8. Here's a good start. Devo's just got to get this one away, and he does. Controls it. Keeps it on his hood as well. Follow-up shots to neutralize Astral. Now Yukio into the corner. Can he find Violent Panda? It's straight back to him. The goal is on target. Violent Panda is a monster. How did he know it was going here?
The hat trick. Yukio just pushing it around the corner.
Oh.
Bluey doesn't get a good piece of it, and he just bombed it. And that's really just all it is. Violent Panda doesn't know the ball's going.
No. His positioning is perfect. He could have moved in for the shot if it went in Yukio's favor. The fact that it pinched out, he immediately adjusted. I mean, I would never adjust fast enough to make that shot. That was just such quick lightning reflexes.
And it is just as well an opportunity, because you realize it's a tougher play to make than the defense is expecting, because it is, you have to, he can see.